So good morning, welcome once again. This is as usual my host Dennis, and I'm still taking you through Microsoft Access 2016 from zero to hero. And we are going to look at another training example that will be very helpful, Microsoft Access. We're going to look at a question, and I request that I take you through that question. And that question is like, using a program of your choice, create a database of the sales. I think you can see it has product ID, product name, quantity, unit price, and quantity returned. Then the instructions: design a table to hold the above records and save it as sales 2015. Create a form you will use to populate the above records on the form. Add a form title, data entry. Create two queries to return the following using all the field names. Items whose quantity is above 100 and save it as above 1000. Items whose first letter is between O and T, save the query as O and T. Add a field name gross sale in the query, hence determine the gross sales for each commodity. Save the query as gross price. Using your answer in the above, create a report saved as gross sale report, then print all your work. That is our question. And when it looks here on the using a program of your choice, create a database. Mainly the program we have learned to create a database is Microsoft Access. Yeah, me, I'm going to use Microsoft Access 2016. But if you use 2007, 2010, 2013, it will still be the same. There will be no difference in the way you will do the things. Now I'm using Windows 10 Enterprise Edition, and I come here, got all apps, my access comes immediately. That is for Windows 10. Windows 7 still, you do the same, you click here, then you look for look for Microsoft Office and you get access, then you open it. Or if you have used it for long, you will find the 20 is already there like mine. So I click on it and it is opening now, and it has come. Now it is here. Me, I'm going to select, I select either new or blank database. But I'm going to say new and blank database. When I say blank database, it will bring me this thing to create. So my database, I'm going to call it sales because that's the name they told me. I think you see here, they entered database saved as sales, and there you get 3 marks. Sales is going to be saved in my in the documents. After that, I say create. It takes some short time and it goes. Now I come to number 2, instructions. Yeah, now we are back to our question. So when you create a table, this table is automatically created, but if you don't want it, you can close it. Then you come here and create a table which you want, create a table. Even you can close, you come and create a table design. Yeah, it will be very simple for you. when you create it immediately, you save. Now our table has to be called sales 2015. So I type in the name sales 2015. Oops, is it having a space or not? It is a complete word, no space. Sales 2015, I say okay. First put the fields. The fields I have product ID. I now put it product ID. Then I got another field. I have product name, then quantity. Quantity, then unit price, quantity returned. Now when you look at these ones, product ID has a text, but it has something that keeps repeating. So we are going to format it. Product ID is a mixture of text and numbers. So text is given high priority. We use cell show text. I'm using the input mask for this thing that is repeating, KFM. So I'm going to put it here. I put your quotations. I think I can. There's something that can. Expression builder. I do this. KFM slash. Then I cross. Then, because there are three numbers. I put series 0, 1, 2, 3. Then I come here to product name, that's a text. Quantity, that's a number. Unit price, that is currency. But the format of currency, I'm going to use the standard one with a comma. And I'm going to make sure that the decimal places are zero. Then I go to quantity returned. That is a number. Then I define my primary key, which is this one. I say primary key. I've successfully made my table. I save. Can I click here? Sales 2015, okay. So my table has been created. If I go to see it in data sheet view, yes. Jambon.
Afande.
I'm seeing there's a problem here. Our currency has refused to behave. Currency. It should be a standard currency. And with zero decimal places. After that, you save. Finally, it has behaved. Now, if you attempt to enter a product, are you seeing that? Your product automatically, that thing is put for you. And I have to delete that because I don't want to. So I close this one. This now we are done with creating a table. We have defined all our fields with their properties. The fields are these ones. product ID, product name, whose data type was a text, this one was a number, this one unified the currency, but a standard currency. Quantity 10, that's a number. Now we have finished this designing a table to hold the records. So far now we have 8 marks. Now we have now working on these 5 marks of the data entry form. Data entry form. We are now going to create a data entry form, and we come here. We go to create. We have form design. Now we have to make sure the table is open for you to create a form. You come here to form, click on it, and your form is made. Well, if you don't want that, let me show you another way and save. No, you can just come here to create, and it's a form design. This one doesn't work, so it is better you say create form, and they bring you a form. They have brought it to you in form, in layout view. We want to put, you know, most forms always have buttons that when you put your data, you enter, then you click the button, your data goes to the database. So we do that in design view to put the button. So I go to design view, and our form, they said, should have a word data entry. So I'm going to change this word and call it data entry. Then here, I want to create a position for the button. I scroll down, then I come to form design. Form design, here I can even change the image. I want to try out change the image. Fill black, fill blue. Yeah, I filled it with blue. Yeah, now okay, let me do that. At least I've put something, data entry form. Data entry, and I can even change how this word appears. Fonts. No. We go to home. Now it is on form design. I can put it blah blah. Yeah, that's it. Now I come here and put a button. My button is here. Okay, these are useful. Put and you see which one will bring button. This is a label. This is a text box. This is a button. You click on it and you move your cursor to where you want it to be. Here. Hold the left mouse button and expand. Then you select record operations to add a new record. If you want to delete, you can use delete. But me, I'm adding, add new record. Next. Then I put text code. This is the word I want to appear. And say enter data. Then I say next. Can even finish. I finish now. Oh, my button is here. Can even expand it after here. This is now. You see, you can easily do anything on it. Even these ones, you can even make them smaller. That's it. You can do anything. You can even design them. Okay, we have done. Now we go to. We go to form view. That's how we can enter our data. Form view. Now my data, the first person is 001. The product name is yogurt 1000. Yogurt. price is 1,000. Unit price is 800, then quantity times 150. 800, 150. I enter. I think it disappears. So now when I go to my table, first cross the table, then I open it. Let me save this one. Save. Now when I go to my table, you seeing it has yogurt? Yeah, my thing has gone there. Now there's another property that I want us to put to the form. We have another thing that I want to make the form to be a pop-up. Form properties. It's something that they call pop-up. OP2RST caption picture read to screen. There's something yes. I'm not seeing the pop-up. It seems it is not there, but there should be something. Pop-up, yeah, it is in the others. Pop-up, I say yes. Then I save. So the moment I close my thing and I open this, it will come as a pop-up. Are you seeing how it is? It's appearing like this. I can move it anywhere. So now I can enter my next record. I think you saw how I made it pop up. I first put it to the design view. Then I right clicked and went to form properties. Then I went to other. Sometimes you may find it here on this line, but maybe it's in others. Pop up was yes or no. So I had to make it no, because initially it was a yes. It was a no, and that's it. We can have. I close my form. I come here. It loads in a pop-up way. And now I got to put my next field, which is Afia 1860. 1 0. Zero, 1 0, and it is called Afia. And there is 1,000, and this is 800, and this is 150. And I enter my data. It has gone. It cannot be reflected immediately. You have to first close and then open. I think you can see my data as it has entered. And it is exact recording of that. Now, I think for easy entering, let me adjust my stuff here. Then adjust my form. I think you can play to where you see. Now you can begin entering. But it is disappearing. No problem, you keep receiving there. Wait for 3-0. Oh, there is something which is 20-0-2-0. Something. I enter my data. I go to 0-0. That is weak. Good flow. 600. I think how easy it is to do this stuff. 100. And to return it is 100. I enter. Me, I don't care what is happening at the back. 02. Mangori. 700. Unit price is 800. Quantum band is 300. Enter your data. I go to the next. 022. Yes.
Morning, sir.
Morning.
Is it
Jambo? I'm still entering the data. There are two, that is pendant. The quantity is 4,000. Unit price is 500. Quantity returned is 10. Enter. Go to the next. 32. Pencils. $2,000. Unit price of a pencil is 50. Quantity returned 21. What's the next step? 003. These are books. Quantity 1,500. 250. Quantity returned 100. Enter data. Little too silly, that's the next thing. Too silly. That would ask. $610. The unit price is 500. And item 10.01. Now I go to the next item, which is the little CD, and that is the rings in bracket photocopy quantity 218,000, then when to return is 07. I enter. Now control 004. Those are bulbs. And the quantity is 800. Unit price is 1000. Control 10.03. You enter. Come again to the last one now. 014. There's a switch. Switch at 10,000. The unit price is 50. Quantity returned is 00. And what's the last one? 024. Product name is Ice Cream 250. This one is 500. Then quantity time is 00. Enter the data. So finally, we are through with entering our data, and I am free. I can close the form. Then I can now close my table. And we open it again. You can right click on it, say open. You can say I have all my items, and good enough, they have arranged themselves alphabetically. That is nice and good. Now I have a next question, which is, you have now fully satisfied up to question what? Question, now we're going to question C, where we are going to create a query. Create a query that using queries to return the following using all the field names. Items whose quantity is above 1000, so if it has above 1000, those are two marks. The criteria will be greater than 1000, so I have to come here. And I come to create, then the query, where? I use query wizard. So the query wizard will say simple query. Okay. This one is all the fields, this one brings only one, but this one brings all of them. I say next. And then what's the title you want to save for the query? We said the title of the query is above 1000. Above 1000. Modify the query design. Okay, that's it. Finish. As you can see, it has broke, but now we have to go to the design view of the query so that we can put our criteria. Quest has brought all the items. Now what we do here on saying whose quantity is above 1000, so we come here to quantity, saying this thing of criteria above one thousand. You run. Oh, that's not working. So there, just put this greater than 1000 and we run. So these are the only quantities that are greater than 1000. You can see it was just a simple query. Just this. If you go to the query builder, you can easily see what I put. I just put this greater than 1000. Full stop. And it worked. Then I run. So I save that query. It's already here. It's already saved. I can even save for formality. Then now we got another query of ours. Items whose first letter is between O and T. Which lover, now I go here, create query wizard. Next, put all the fields. Next, what do you want to see? The query name is called O and T. O and T. And you finish. The query is done, but it is in data sheet view. Go to design view so that you can put the criteria that they wanted. The criteria is that the product name is between O and T. Now we have what you call wild cards. So I can go to the builder so that I easily see between O star and T star. Then I say okay. And I run my query. My query has brought me items that are between O and T. If you can see, we have O, P, we have P, Q, P, P is here, R, S. Those are the letters that are between O and T. And our query is already saved. We can save it for formality because we had already saved it. Now we go to the next. Add a field name, gross sale, in a query, hence determine the gross sales for each commodity. Now I'm going to make a query that is bringing gross sale. I come here, go to create, query wizard, and I'm saving this query as gross price. Gross price. I say finish. Now it has brought all the things. There is no criteria. So I go to design view because I want to add a field here, and that field is called the gross sale. So I say, and go to the builder, and it is expanding. I say gross sale. I put this, I think those, then because my field here, gross sale is quantity times unit price. So it is quantity times unit price. Remember, you follow what you wrote here. I'll finish now. I say okay. Then I run. When I run, you see it has included gross sale among my tables. Now I say save. Now when I want to modify this, and modify it. Because this currency stuff, I'm not understanding it. Can you go back to the design view? And I see. That's enough. That's both our query. We can easily see the gross price. Now, one is to reduce the decimal prices. Something that I reduce by the decimal places. I want to reduce the decimal places. I don't know how to do that. Okay, no. Let's leave it like that. Because we have done our part. We have bagged all the marks. Now we are left with C. We have bagged the 4 marks. Using your quantity, your answer in the above, create a report, save as gross seller report. Now I'm going to use this query and create a report. Create report. A second there. Very simple. Report. The report is called what? Gross seller report. Call it gross seller report. On Thursday. And as you can see, it is a good report. It's a good report. It's a good report. Very nice report. A nice report. Great setup report. Now it's, I serve as what? Gross seller report. You say okay? I think I've successfully satisfied all the questions. What I'm left with is printing my work. Now to print here this report, you say Ctrl P. I'm going to print a Foxit reader or because I don't have any other printer connected here. So what I do, number of copies, this is one, or I print. Okay. It is printing grocery report. It is printing it. And I think you see how my report will look like. No, it has brought a lot of things outside me. But it is a nice report, you can see. Now to be good, if I wanted to do using the margins, can go to the report design view of the report. Then I can modify and reduce the size of my scale. Product ID. You can see, you reduce the draw one, you see? That one you reduce. You don't touch the upper one, the rep. Then you go, you save. I go to the report view. I think you can see now. What did I do? The same thing that I draw cells. So I start from here. Zero can mean like that. I save. Now I go to my report view. I think you can see if I print, it will fit well. Saved it on my desktop. It's printing and very soon I will show it. So this is the one, now it is looking more clear. I think you can see. Oh, there is something there. Something. And the design view. I think there's one thing that is not fitting well. Because I'm seeing quantity returned. Quantity returned is not fitting well. Now this is okay. Report view. Yeah, this is clear now. Now this is a good report. So, I've showed you how to print. And that's it for now. I remain your instructor, Dennis. I hope you have learned a lot of things, and above all, I wish you all the best. Thank you. Subscribe to my YouTube channel, Dennis. Subscribe. Thank you. God bless you.